This is a production of PBS 39.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Amy Burkett. Many of you might have visited Lafayette College in Easton, but how well do you know the history of its namesake, the Marquis de Lafayette? Nicole Brewer spent the day on campus to learn more about the life and legacy of what some call America's Marquis.
It was a birthday celebration fit for a king, complete with music, dancing, and plenty of food. Only it wasn't for a king, it was for a marquis.
I was born Marie Joseph Paul Yves Roche Gilbert Dumotier.
Better known as the Marquis de Lafayette.
We've been planning for this event, which commemorates the 250th anniversary of the birth date of the Marquis de Lafayette.
Thousands of students from Lafayette College came to the campus quad to enjoy 18th century cuisine, folk dancing, and the arrival of the Marquis.
What we hope to do is combine very serious, straightforward academic presentations with fun events that will provide students a chance to participate.
At your namesake college, welcome back to America, Monsieur le Marquis de Lafayette. We welcome you here.
So what did he think of his party?
It was wonderful. I was received, like I said during the speech, like a king.
And did the students have a good time?
I mean, with the live band playing in the background and the food they have out here, I mean, it's not often we get a free meal around the park, so it's always good to get everybody out.
And while some students knew quite a bit about the Marquis,
the more you read about him, the more he becomes an important figure in history.
Others hope to learn more.
To tell you the truth, I don't know too much about him. I know he was French and fought in the war.
And while the public may view Lafayette as a distant historical figure, the college hopes to bring that image to life through highlighting who Lafayette was as a person and the types of things he stood for.
Lafayette was one of the most dedicated and assiduous believers in the importance of liberty and personal freedom. And much of what we live with today, much of the benefits that we have today, are the result of what he believed in.
Born on September 6, 1757, in the Chateau de Chavignac in south-central France, he was the son of French aristocrats. He entered the French army at age 14, and 5 years later set sail to America to make his mark on the Revolution.
The king did not want him to go. His powerful father-in-law did not want him to go. In fact, he left without even telling his wife he was going.
And despite rejection by the U.S. Congress upon his arrival, he managed to win favor with George Washington, who later promoted him to commander.
At the beginning, he was young, he was green, but he learned quickly.
With Washington, Lafayette fought in the Battle of Brandywine in 1777, where he was wounded. Serving without pay, he played a key role in the Siege of Yorktown in 1781, the battle that ended the war.
Lafayette was extremely important in bringing in the French, who were vital to America's victory.
During the war and after, Washington and Lafayette developed a strong bond as mentor and protege, but also likened themselves to father and son.
That friendship was very important to both men, and I think each of them brought out something in the other.
A friendship based on mutual respect and admiration, best shown in written letters and artifacts.
If anything truly captures the friendship between Lafayette and Washington, it is this key and this letter.
Presented to Washington by Lafayette in 1790, the key to the Bastille represented the storming of the French prison, which marked the beginning of the French Revolution.
He says, I'm giving you this key. It is a tribute which I owe as a son to my adoptive father, as an aide-de-camp to my general, as a missionary of liberty to its patriarch.
As head of the French National Guard, Lafayette fought for personal liberty and freedom, and eventually became an abolitionist.
In fact, in this letter, Lafayette wrote to Washington and asked him to join with him in an experiment to free slaves.
But Washington wouldn't. That is until his death in 1799.
With his will, Washington freed his slaves, and Lafayette was one of the main influences on Washington.
Lafayette continued his involvement in the French Revolution until it turned radical in 1792.
When Lafayette fled from the excesses of the French Revolution, he was captured at the border. He was trying to get to America.
Lafayette was released in 1797 and returned to America in 1824. Nearly 50 years after the American Revolution, Lafayette's farewell tour served to congratulate Americans for a job well done.
He was invited by Congress and by the president. He went to every state in the Union. He was greeted by huge crowds. People lined up to meet him,
including a group of Estonians.
Lafayette did not come to Easton, but Easton went to him. About 200 of our citizens went down the Delaware in Durham boats to Philadelphia for that great celebration.
And in December of 1824, that same group founded a college, Lafayette College, an institution that 200 years later proudly pays tribute to the man behind its name. For Tempo, I'm Nicole Brewer reporting.